Harvey Weinstein's 10-year marriage to Marchesa designer Georgina Chapman was a sexless business arrangement. The 10-year marriage of disgraced movie mogul Harvey Weinstein and his estranged wife Georgina Chapman is being called a sexless business arrangement by one friend of the couple. Friends of the pair tell The Sun that their marriage was only to promote her clothing label Marchesa. Weinstein reportedly forced the leading ladies in his films to wear his wife's gowns on the red carpet in exchange for her turning a blind eye to his alleged cheating and harassment. Georgina is a lovely person. But the idea she had no idea what was going on, I find impossible to believe. Anything is possible, it's just highly unlikely. She put up with an awful lot. But it worked for both of them, one of her friends told The Sunday. However, despite what Chapman's friends have said, the designer and the disgraced mogul do have a daughter and a son together, India Pearl, who is 7 years old, and Dashiell Max Robert, who is 4. Since the allegations against Weinstein continue to mount, the future of her fashion line has been called into question. Multiple anonymous reports confirm that employees are fleeing Georgina Chapman's company after Helzberg Diamonds cancelled a collaboration with Marchesa that would have been launched this month. A top fashion publicist told the New York Post that everyone is trying to leave. Chapman had quickly distanced herself from Weinstein when she announced on Tuesday she was separating from her husband of 10 years. Weinstein has been accused of sexual misconduct by over 30 women. However, fashion insiders say the separation may not be enough to salvage the brand's reputation. Wedding stylist Diane Lloyd Roth said, "I tell my brides to bring pages from magazines, and Marchesa is always included. Some clients were going to go look at Marchesa. And now they're getting cold feet," she said. "They don't want the association. The first question when someone's getting married is, who are you wearing?" Chapman founded the company with business partner Karen Craig. Chapman and Craig also cancelled the brand's summer preview 2018 preview, increasing nervousness among the staff. A leading Hollywood publicist anonymously told the Daily Beast, "This is a f**king tsunami right now. I don't think it is the end of it. I don't think we've seen all the collateral damage play out for all kinds of players. There is a sense of real relief that it has come out, but also a sense that there are more things that will come to light. It's really affecting every part of the business." Weinstein had allegedly caused problems in the business before, verbally abusing staff and publicly promoting Chapman, but not Craig. Marchesa was a Hollywood staple and a preferred choice for celebrities to wear on red carpets. Cate Blanchett, Jennifer Lopez, Halle Berry, Emma Watson, Renee Zellweger, Blake Lively and Kate Hudson are all among actresses that have worn clothing from the fashion label. "I do think some stores will drop them," said one major retailer whose stores carry Marchesa in the US, to the New York Post. In fashion, editors and buyers only go with what's cool. But they won't suffer overseas. I think they can weather the storm. Despite Georgina Chapman quickly distancing herself from Weinstein, there is an unsavory association between the brand and Weinstein, and likely many savvy celebrities and wearers of her brands will want to steer clear of this for the short term at least, Elizabeth Schubert, director of marketing at Selesage, told the Daily Beast. One publicist told the Hollywood Reporter, "No star is ever going to want to wear the brand again." More than 30 women have now come forward with allegations of sexual harassment against Weinstein, the man once described as god of the film industry. Saturday Night Live slammed Weinstein last night when Colin Jost said he has been accused of multiple acts of sex assault. "He doesn't need sex rehab, he needs a specific facility where no one could see him, where there are metal bars. And it's a prison." Bob Weinstein lashed out at his older brother in an interview with The Hollywood Reporter, describing him as a crazy liar who has no remorse whatsoever. The movie producer has been seen just twice, once in New York, the day after the first claims were made on October 6. He had already given a statement to the New York Times apologizing for his behavior but insisting through Bloom that he had never engaged in non-consensual sexual activity. On October 11, a week after his first remarks, he appeared again in Los Angeles but has since seemingly checked into a rehab center to receive treatment for sex addiction.